Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, in this video I am going to discuss about basic introduction of frames and trusses as well as the types of frames and trusses. So let's start the introduction video of plane frame and trusses. So here in this particular lesson, I am going to discuss about complete description of trusses, like what is trusses, what are the application of trusses and mathematical conditions related to trusses, as well as different types of frames and trusses. So let's start. Here, if we define frames and trusses, so basically frames and trusses are considered as the framed structure which generally used to resist deformation of any kind of external force. So here if we define trusses or frames, so it is called framed structure, and the assembly of number of members or number of bars which are joined together. Here if we consider number of bars or number of rods or number of members, and these members are joined together by some joining methods, so in that case this particular structure is considered as the frame structure or assembled structure which are joined by different joining methods. And different joining methods we can consider as welding, riveting by nuts and bolts, pin joint, etc. There are different joining methods. So these number of bar are generally joined by different joining methods, by riveting, welding, nuts and bolts, pin joint, etc. And that particular frame structure is called plane frame and trusses. And this particular truss or frame are generally used to resist deformation against external loading. See, there are different systems or different assemblies. If those assemblies are subjected to number of forces or external forces, so because of external force, we consider deformation in that particular system. So to resist deformation, we generally use assembly or the frame structure to resist deformation. So main work of the truss or the frame is what? It is always resist deformation against external loading, and this frame structure is considered as the assembly of number of members or bars. So this is the basic definition of truss. Here I already told you about the joining points or joining methods. These joining methods are riveting, welding, nuts and bolts, pin joint. There are a lot of joining methods. And here, if we define the members, that is called bar. So bar in the frame structure can be in the form of angle section, it can be in the form of T section, and it can be in the form of I section. There are a lot of sections we consider. So these particular sections we consider for the bar in the frame structure. And if we define the particular drawing of the structure or particular drawing of the frame or the trusses, so here you can see this diagram. This diagram is generally representing the drawing or the detail of the trusses. Here you can see these lines, these inclined line, horizontal lines are representing the members of the trusses. So we can mark these line as M, and it is representing the member, means bars in the trusses. And here you can see this particular term. So this is representing the supports. And here at support, we generally consider reactions as the external force. And here you can see P. So this P is representing as the external force, and it is applicable at the joint. So here you can see these lines, this inclined line, and this particular horizontal line is joined at these three points. So these three points are called joint, and this line is representing the member of the truss. So here we generally consider how many terms in the truss: members, joints, support and reactions at the support, and external force. So with the help of these terms, we can avoid deformation or we can resist deformation against external loading. This is the P, and P is considering as the external loading. So because of this external loading, whatever deformation we are getting, we can resist with the help of this construction of the frame structure. So the frame structure or trusses or frames we generally use to resist deformation against external loading. And here I told you here about the member. So this M is representing the member. This particular point which are joining the member are considered as the joint, and these terms are representing as the support, and at support we generally consider reaction. That I will tell you later how we can consider the reaction and how we can calculate this term M and J in different types of frames. As I told you about bars, so bars is considered as the member of the frame or truss, and this bar is always considered as two-way force member. Two-way force member means on this particular bar, that is called the member which is represented by M. So on this particular bar, we only consider force like tensile force or compressive force in two direction. For example, here we are considering this particular line as the bar or the member. So if we apply force on this particular bar, so the tensile force will be act in both the direction. Here these two points are represented as the joint, and this total bar is represented as the member. So whatever force we are applying, either it is tensile force or it is compressive force, this force will be applicable in both the direction. See here, there is a compressive force. So compressive force will act in the direction of the joint. The force which is compressing the joint, so that force is considered as the compressive force. And the force which is extending the joint, that particular force is called the tensile force on the bar or on the member. Now here I am going to draw the tensile force diagram also. So here in this particular bar, you can see this is the member, and these two end points are considered as the joint, which are joined with another member. So if we draw here the tensile force, so this particular force is expanding this particular joint. So the tensile force we will draw like this, and compressive force we will draw like this. So bar is always considered as two-way force member, and on the bar there is only axial force act, that is tensile or compressive force only. There is no other force, there is no normal force act on the bar. So this is the bar or information about the bar. And if we see the application of the truss, see, we have seen a lot of things about the truss. I already explained a lot of things about the truss, like basic introduction about the sections, about joints, about members. But here if we see the basic application of truss, so where we apply trusses and frame, so here is the answer. Here roofs for the buildings, for the railway station or platforms, here we apply the concept of trusses. So trusses are generally used on roofs of different buildings and different structures like railway platforms, airport, there are lot many buildings, and different kind of bridges. If you have seen the bridges, so to resist the deformation against the external loading on bridges, we generally form frame or trusses on bridges. So roofs and bridges are the most important application of trusses. Here you can see a diagram. This is the diagram of the truss or frame, and as I told you, this particular line is represented as the member, and the points which are joining these members are called joint. So these points we considered as joint. And one more thing you have to remember here, that is the external force will always act at the joints only. No external force will act on member. On member we will only consider axial tensile force and axial compressive force. These two forces we will consider only on the member. No external force will act on the member, like this condition is not at all applicable for the members. Here, force will not act perpendicular to the member. The force which is acting on the member, that is only axial tensile force and axial compressive force in two way, in both the direction. So, this is the application of loading, and at the support point, we only consider reaction. That reaction depends on the types of support that I will tell you later. By hinge support, we can draw two reactions, vertical and the horizontal reaction. And if we are considering roller support, so in roller support, we consider only vertical reaction. So when we do the mathematical analysis, I will tell you about these conditions in detail. So this is the basic information about the trusses. Now let's see how many trusses or how many types of trusses we generally consider. So here I am going to tell you one by one about different types of trusses. So first type of truss is, or frame is, plane frame. Second type of frame is space frame. And third type of frame is statically determinate frame. And fourth type of frame is statically indeterminate frame. So I will discuss about these four type of frames. Then I will discuss about some other types of frame. So first we will discuss about the plane frame. So, if we are considering frame or the member of the frame, all members are lying in the same plane and the force acting along the same plane. So, that particular frame is called the plane frame. Here, whatever number of member we are considering or how many number of bars we are considering, all the member are lying in the same plane. For example, roofs. So, in roofs, we generally consider all the members generally lie in horizontal plane. So, roof is the perfect example of the plane frame. So, here we can say if the members are lying in the same plane, as well as forces which is acting on the frame is lying along the same plane. So, that particular frame is called the plane frame. And the example is roof. And one more example we can consider, that is bridge. So, roofs and bridges are the perfect example of plane frame. Now, let us see the second type of frame, that is space frame. So, in space frame, we consider all the members or all the bars does not lie in the same plane, opposite to plane frame. If the members does not lie in the same plane, as well as the forces which is acting on that particular frame are also not in the same plane, so that particular frame is called space frame. For example, tripod. In tripod, we consider three sides, and if we consider three sides as the force member on that particular side, so all the forces are acting in different plane. So that is the perfect example of space frame. And suspension towers are also one of the example of space frame. So this is second type of frame. Now third type of frame is statically determinate frame. So here we have number of members in the frame, and if we want to find out equations of static equilibrium for that particular frame, or if we apply the condition of static equilibrium to find out number of forces which are applicable on that particular frame, and these three or whatever number of equilibrium condition we are considering are sufficient to find out the unknown forces or forces which are applicable on the frame, so that particular frame is called statically determinate frame. For example, if we have three number of conditions of equilibrium, like summation of fx equals to 0, summation of fy equals to 0, or summation of moment equals to 0. So in that particular condition, we can say the frame is statically determinate frame. So here we can find out all the unknown forces which are applicable on the frame with the help of these three equations. And if these three equations are sufficient to find out these forces, so the frame is called statically determinate frame. Next type of frame is statically indeterminate frame. This is just opposite to statically determinate frame. Here, if we apply equilibrium conditions, like if we have three equilibrium condition and number of unknowns are more than the equilibrium condition, so that frame will become statically indeterminate frame. If we are not able to find out the unknown forces or unknown values of the frame by the given conditions of equilibrium, so that particular frame is called statically indeterminate frame. Equations of static equilibrium are not sufficient to determine the forces, and here we also consider the deformation. Deformation is also applicable in this particular type of frame, statically indeterminate frame. So this is about statically determinate and statically indeterminate frame, and these are the condition which we are going to use to solve the problems which is related to frames and trusses. Now, next three types of frame are most important types of frame, because most of these trusses are based on these three types of frames. So first type is perfect truss, second type is over rigid truss or frame, and third type is collapsible truss. And these three types of trusses are based on one equation, and the equation is, for perfect truss we consider m equals to 2j minus 3, and for over rigid truss we consider m is greater than 2j minus 3, and for collapsible truss we consider m is less than 2j minus 3, where m is number of members, j is number of joints. So here, as per the perfect truss, we can say if m, number of members, is equals to 2 into number of joints minus 3. So if these two terms are equivalent, so this particular kind of truss will be our perfect truss. And here, if we define over rigid truss, so it will be m greater than 2j minus 3, means number of member should be greater than this 2 into number of joint minus 3, means this left side is greater than the right side conditions, so the truss will be over rigid truss. Now third is collapsible truss. So collapsible truss is opposite to over rigid truss. If number of members are less than 2j minus 3, so this particular truss is called the collapsible truss. Here, if we define by the diagram, so here are the diagram which is related to perfect truss, over rigid truss or collapsible truss, or it can call as perfect frame, over rigid frame and collapsible frame. So this particular condition is representing as m equals to 2j minus 3, means number of members are equals to 2j minus 3. And number of members, how we can count? Here, this particular line, vertical line, horizontal line or inclined line, only lines are considered as members. So we can count here members 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So here we have 7 members. So all the members we will mark 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 members we have. So we will write here 7. That is equals to 2j minus 3. So we will mark the number of joints here. So number of joints will be, this will be one joint, this will be second joint, this will be third joint, this will be fourth joint, and this will be our fifth joint. So how many joints we have here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we will put number of joint in place of j. So it will be 2 into j minus 3. So it will be equivalent to 7. So left side is equals to right side. It means this condition is satisfied. So our equation is representing the equation of perfect frame. Similarly, we can write here the condition of over rigid frame. So the condition of over rigid frame is m greater than 2j minus 3. So if number of members are greater than 2j minus 3, so this particular frame is called over rigid frame. And here for collapsible frame, we can write down the equation as m is less than 2j minus 3. So here we will count the number of members, then we will count the number of joints, and we will put these values in place of m and j, and whatever condition we will get, on the basis of that particular condition, we can define the types of frame. either it will be perfect frame or over rigid frame or collapsible frame. So this is the complete description of different types of frames and trusses. Thanks for watching this video. Stay tuned with Ikeda and subscribe to Ikeda.